as you could tell, somebody just drug this thing out of a barn. It's got still the rust, and it's like it just came off the racetrack. I think the last time this car was raced, probably Martinsville in September, you know, and it's just like it came off the racetrack. It's amazing. I mean, you know, just to look at this car, we looked at it, and everything on it is just perfect. I mean, it, you can tell exactly like this thing was a real race car, you know, and like I was saying, you know, you can see where move the stuff from the left to the right for the road course stuff, and it's an awesome car. It really is. Like I said, just I mean, it looks, it's just perfect. Everything in it's just, you look underneath the hood and you can tell it's a real race car. It's still got the duct tape on the base of the windshield. I mean, you know, it's just like I said, what's the neat about this car? It's like you, stuff we would do now, and you see owners, they say, okay, we won the Daytona 500. We'll leave everything on it, leave the graffiti on it, leave everything. You know, I want that car. And, you know, it's ironic this car here looks like the same thing. You just come home and you just put it up and, you know, 40 or 50 years later, here it's back, you know, and it's, so it's an awesome piece. You know, like I said, everything on it's perfect. You know, once you get on the lift, you can really see, I mean, the stuff underneath. I mean, you know, it's just like how we cobbled stuff up back then, you know what I'm saying? Because I think that's about the time we all learned how to wire weld and stuff like that. So it's like, you know, but it's a neat car. You know, everyone who gets this car, they're going to get a real piece of history right there, especially with Cale and his history and Junior and his history. You know, I mean, it's like I said, this is going to be something really to put in your collection here.
This particular car, we originally started running these cars in 1978 at Junior Johnson's, and we had First National City Traveler's checks. And that's nice when you think you got a bank for a sponsor, you got all the money in the world. But back in that era, $425,000 was our entire budget for the race team for the year. But when Busch came along, Anheuser-Busch stepped up, wanted Cale Yarborough. We had already won some good championships. Junior had won them in 76, 77, and Herb Nabb had left in 1977. So Junior hired Travis Carter and myself to come in as crew chiefs. So that was a model change deal. We came in with the Oldsmobiles and had a lot of success on the speedways, but we ran the Chevrolet Monte Carlos on the road courses as well as the short track.
Remember that old Banjo wedge bolts? 12 rounds per inch.
Oh yeah.
Extension for master cylinders. You go to Martinsville, you'd have one on there about like that. But old fan shrouds, wonder people didn't lose their fingers.
I was getting ready to say the same thing.
Chris Paulson and those guys with those electric fans, they had it going on. Remember old throttle rod right there? Mm-hmm. That's stainless steel.
Man, this thing's got the Hurst Earhart's on it.
Oh, yeah.
But I wonder what pad's in that.
There ain't no telling. Hard as a rock.
That's got those Ford spindles.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's like anything else. The stock car stuff hadn't really come along at that time.
No.
And, you know, you didn't know that much about it. But, you know, you look at the spindle bolts and stuff like that, it's even got the small spindle bolts in it. But you wasn't going to break none of that stuff because it's cast, it's iron anyway. Mm-hmm. But the biggest sway bar we had in the world back then was an inch and a quarter. Those 180 headers, you could hear Cale's car on the racetrack anywhere at any time over anybody else's car. Very few people ran them. The fan shroud, the fan blade itself, all the front duct work, it conducts air from the front of the car into the radiator for cooling. All this stuff is right. And
it's awesome.
How many times have you seen a chrome bumper on a car this day and time?
That's the real deal right
that,
there.
That is literally the chrome horn right there. And when you looked up and seen that 11 behind you, the guy in the seat, he was not afraid to use that chrome horn right there.
Like I said, it's a neat car. You can see the brake ducts and the openings and the, for the oil coolers and all that stuff. So it's a pretty special car.
At the end of the day, that tradition right there, you can't buy it. But somebody was smart enough to keep that car and to keep it and preserve it and just let other people look at it, that's something in itself.